coming in for your long-term play, we have Go Go Power Rangers number 21.
Right, so if you guys have been watching, if you're a long-time followers of the Simpleman's Comics YouTube channel, you know that we have done two interviews with Arun Singh. Both interviews, we talked about this upcoming story, Necessary Evil. And if you have watched the Bolo show, you know I highlighted Power Rangers number 40. This is the second story, the second book in this Necessary Evil story. And why this is important is we saw this with the last important story, Shattered Grid, and then in Necessary Evil is the follow-up to Shattered Grid. Go-Go Power Rangers, which tends to have kind of a lighter art style, gets looked at as almost like a kid's book in comparison to the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers main book. But in fact, it is just, it tells a different segment of the story, a different area of the story. So in the past, it got kind of underordered and slept on. And guess what, guys? That happened again with this one. Our retailers in the field let us know yesterday this book is now completely sold out at Diamond. So whatever copies are in retailers' hands, that is all you are going to see. And guess who let us know way, way, way back when that was going to happen? Arun Singh. He put out what he calls the Bolo Audible. And I'll tell you, Arun, you can go ahead and take the Bolo term anytime you want to, my man, because every time he puts that Bolo out, he is right. And he let us know, man, people are under-ordering this book. And another reason why this is important is because the writer of the series, Ryan Parrott, is now the writer of Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, and he is writing the Necessary Evil story. The previous writer was Dennis Hopeless, who is now goes by his actual name, Dennis Hallam, who he kind of like kickstarted this whole Mighty Morphin Power Rangers Lord Draken craze. And here we get the follow-up to issue 40, where we had the first appearance. Issue 40 gave us that first appearance of the Omega Rangers. And here we kind of get their origin story, and we get kind of like a surprise cameo from a new ranger, as well as, again, continuing this story in a lower printed issue. And we saw this with Shattered Grid. Power Ranger collectors, they want the whole series. They want the whole story. And to do that, what they're going to end up doing is they're going to want both of these kind of releases, Go-Go Power Rangers and Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. And you can bank on Go-Go Power Rangers always having the smaller print run. Now here we get a chance to look at some of the variants. You see kind of the unique variants. Go-Go Power Rangers likes to use variant themes. So their incentives are usually homages. They, in the past, they've been homages to like 80s movies and 90s movies. Here we get the No Doubt Tragic Kingdom homage, which I've had a conversation with a couple people. It's the first CD I ever bought. Was back in the day, I actually, going through pictures from my father's funeral, I found myself in an old No Doubt t-shirt that I completely forgot I even owned and was a little embarrassed I was actually rocking to middle school. But there's been some popularity with that Rita Repulsa cover that you can see on the far right of your screen. You're also getting these yearbook picture variants that we're seeing there. So you get kind of the one, I think it's Jason there, you get the yearbook picture. Go-Go Power Rangers 21, again, sold out at Diamond. Retailers cannot order more. We already know, if you at your LCS, how many of you out there are really going to your LCS and seeing a stack of Power Rangers books? It's not out there. You may have seen a little bit of an increased order for Power Rangers 40 because there was so much buzz on that issue. But you're not going to see it. You're not going to see it going into this Go-Go Power Rangers series. But maybe this issue will bring some light to that. So while it hasn't yet secondary market popped off, if you go and look at sales of Power Rangers 40, you're starting to see increasing number of sales. You're starting to see an increasing number of the price creeping up. You had that boom when it first came out, and then it dropped off as the supply increased, as people got their copies in the mail, put them up on eBay, and now you're starting to see the dry up and the move. Also, Power Rangers is in the news for their San Diego Comic-Con variant, because they're releasing a very special San Diego Comic-Con variant for that. Brian and I actually knew about this in advance, but it was something that, you know, we're not allowed to share. And we want to always respect our industry contacts and the things that they bless us with. But San Diego Comic-Con, if you guys are there, check out the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers 40 variant with that Goni Montez cover that features the Orange Ranger. This is done for Make-A-Wish. There is a child fighting cancer, and he kind of created this character, this Orange Ranger character. And the people at Boom Studios and Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, they wanted to create a book and actually make this character reality, and they're going to be selling this book at San Diego Comic-Con, and the money goes to benefit the Make-A-Wish Foundation. And it's just an amazing thing that Boom is doing. And us at CBSI and Simpleman's Comics, we love those initiatives. That's why, again, we're donating money from every variant release that we do to the St. Jude's Children's Hospital, because we want to be active in that community. I think it's important. As speculators, we take from the hobby to also be giving back. And so I think that the people at Boom, they're aware of where their audience is, and they're receptive to the people that are so invested in the Power Rangers. And it was cool to see them do this for this young kid, man. And our heart goes out to him and his family for everything they go through. Obviously, both Brian and my family have been affected by cancer and disease and things like that. So just really kind of a cool story. Doesn't necessarily have to do with Go-Go Power Rangers 21, but there is mainstream – I hate to make it about speculation, but there's a lot of mainstream media news going out right now about that Make-A-Wish book, and those are the kind of things that are going to draw attention to this necessary evil storyline and what's going on, and the reason why we picked this as a spec. And finally, I always talk about follow the money, and when we've got a guy who's the VP of marketing who is willing to put his reputation and his own in the I'm going to let the market prove me wrong. It's going to dry up and be impossible to find. And that's what always works with properties like this, is when Power Rangers fans are trying to put that run together and they can't get number 21, that's when that price is going to jump. And we've seen random issues in Mighty Morphin Power Rangers be $25, $30, just because the supply of that issue has dried up.
So there you have it. That's Jack's long-term play. Again, if you want to see more about this book or Arun talking about it, we do have the interview with Arun on the channel. It's under the Indie Spotlight series. Definitely check that out. And like he said, they do have the Make-A-Wish. So if you're at San Diego Comic-Con, make sure you look for that Make-A-Wish exclusive variant. But...